What's up, guys? Today we're going to be going over a good question. Should you buy or build your gaming PC? Now, I've seen a lot of questions asked on forums, on Facebook groups, on, hey, should I buy a pre-build or should I be building my own PC? Or, hey, I want to build my own PC. What parts do I need? Or, hey, is the price on this pre-build better? Can I get a better price? What parts should I be looking for? Where should I sacrifice? Where should I upgrade? A lot of different questions. So today, I'm going to show you how to go through a PC build, what you need to look for, and how I just recently helped out one of my buddies who's going to buy a pre-build for about $1,500. I probably saved about $300 to $400 on a gaming PC that's comparable to what he was going to buy. So for those of you who are looking to build your first gaming PC, there's plenty of videos out there on the internet that will show you step-by-step instructions. In fact, I'm going to do one later this week when the rest of my parts arrive for my buddy's computer that I'm building. So stay tuned, hit the like and subscribe button, and hit the little notification bell to see what I come up with next week. So you have to understand what components need to go inside a computer. The first thing I usually start with is a CPU. Do I want to go Intel or do I want to go Ryzen? Now, there's a difference between them. Now, if you're doing pure gaming, Intel's better. If you're doing multitasking, Ryzen's better. But if you look at Ryzen, it is a better bang for your buck on performance, and it does quite good in gaming, and the multi-threading is awesome. Ryzen seems to be coming up from behind Intel to take over the number one spot. I'm seeing more and more Ryzen builds than I am of Intel builds, just due to the budget-friendly price points that they have on all their CPUs. Well, which one do I buy? Do I buy i7, i9? Do I buy the Ryzen 5? Do I buy the Ryzen 7? Do I buy the Ryzen 9? Well, they all have different performance levels, and that depends on what you're going to be doing with it. That's the first thing you need to do. And if you're going to take time to build your own PC, you got to take time to look into the research, to look to see which one's best going to fit your needs. If I had to take a guess, most people out there can probably get away with the 3600 from Ryzen or the new 5600, which is best bang for your buck performance out there in the middle of the road. 6 cores, 12 threads, does more than most people needed to do on an everyday basis. So after you have your CPU selected, you then have to go choose your motherboard. Now, there's a million different motherboards out there, different manufacturers, different chipsets, different generations of what they're going to use for. So you got to really do your research to make sure that your CPU is compatible with the motherboard that you're selecting. Also, you have to keep in mind the size of your case. Does your motherboard fit inside your case? Is it too big or too small? So make sure that you understand what size of motherboard you need for your case. RAM, this is an easy one. How much RAM do you need? 16 gigabytes is plenty for most gamers and most multitaskers. Unless you're doing intense video editing, you can go up to 32 or more. Kind of personal preference if you want to go up above and beyond 16 gigabytes. But you want to make sure you keep in mind that Ryzen does like higher clock speed RAM. I've done a lot of Ryzen builds where if you buy a 2600 megahertz kit or a 2900 megahertz kit or anything like that, it doesn't like it and sometimes won't post. So I recommend always having 3000 and higher megahertz RAM when you go with a Ryzen build. Intel isn't so picky. And for the graphics card. Now, this is where a lot of people can overspend and or underspend depending on what they're using it for. Now, we'd all love to have a 3090 out there right now if you want to spend $2,000 to $3,000 on a graphics card, but that's not realistic for most people. So this is where you have to do a lot of research on seeing, hey, what performance do I get in certain games that I play personally or games in the future? Now, a lot of these cards, mid-range cards, can do 60 frames at 1080p, no problem on AAA titles. So there's a million videos out there of what GPUs do what and how you can compare NVIDIA to AMD and what the performance is and what you should be buying for your computer. And with prices being the way they are, this is where you can actually save a lot of money in a current build. Power supply. You got to make sure you have enough power for the components inside the computer. Most people would be pretty good with 650 to 750 watt power supply if you're doing a mid-range gaming PC and have some upgrade ability later down the road. But if you're going with a 3080 or 3090, if you can get your hands on one, now you got to bump up your power supply. It has to be 850 to 1000 watt power supply depending on what card you get and how much performance you want out of it. Storage. This is a pretty easy one. Most people use an SSD for their operating system and then they buy a hard disk drive, which is HDD. Which is cheaper for more storage, usually buys 2 terabyte, 4 terabyte, or 6 terabyte in order to store their games on. They don't last as long as SSDs, but it's a cheaper alternative route to get a lot of storage for your games. Simple. You can use PC Part Picker to put your parts in there to make sure that they're all compatible. Not only that, it gives you a list of where these parts are available at the best price. So you can compare Amazon to Newegg, Newegg to B&H, B&H to Best Buy to make sure that you're getting the best deal for your build. So let's take a look at my buddy's build that he sent me where I saved him a little bit of money this week. I'll show you exactly what I went through, what I looked at on his PC build, and then what parts I selected that would better suit his needs and what he's doing. Alright, so looking at this CyberPower build he sent me, to take a look at it, he's going to spend $1,500. So let's take a look at some of these specs. So of course they got the case on here. They went with the Intel processor i5-1066, which is 6 cores, 12 threads. The newer generation of CPU, so it is a higher performance, but the price is higher. On this one, they did go with an AIO to cool the CPU, which is, it's an upgrade, but it's an area where you would also save money. As for hard drives, they went with a 240 gigabyte SSD with a 1 terabyte hard drive combo. Not bad, just like I said earlier, what we want to build. Going down here, memory, 16 gigabytes, dual channel memory, Crucial Ballistics, 3000 megahertz RAM, not bad. Just did an Asus Prime motherboard. This one does have Wi-Fi, so that's a plus. Gives a little bit more specs. 600 watt power supply. For the graphics card, they just said GeForce RTX 2060. Now, for the most part, when they do this, they're putting in a blower style fan. It's not like the EVGA card that they show in the picture. It could be a random card, whatever they usually send you. Usually, it's the reference design, and usually it's a blower-style motor, so it is louder. Temps aren't as good on as normal cards, so some things to look into. So before shipping and taxes, he's paying $1,540. So is this a good deal? If you put these parts in a build, it comes out probably about $50 to $100, somewhere in that range less if you built it yourself. But this does give a 3-year warranty, which that is a plus to this build. But you do have to ship it back to them, and you have to wait and other certain. So that's some ups and downs of that. But for the most part, pre-built, who knows. But here, let's look at a comparable build that I built him, what we ended up doing. So our total build over here, what I'm showing. So I went with a Ryzen 5, which is Ryzen build. Previous generations, because it's so hard to get your hands on a 5600X this year due to scalpers and all the other stuff that's going on. This is a 6-core, 12-thread processor also. So most people are like, well, what's the difference? They're both 6 cores, 12-thread. But if you compare the two, now the Intel is better performance. This is a newer generation, but the last generation of Ryzen is just as good. They're both 6 cores, 12 threads, 4.1 gigahertz to 3.6 gigahertz, which is pretty similar, something that an average everyday consumer won't really notice. If you scroll down, it gives some details on FPS, you know, how much frames, but this also depends on your graphics card that you're pairing with it. Effective speed shows you it's 14% faster, which again, hard to kind of tell for an everyday user. Has overclock scores on here, gives a full breakdown of it. But the value of this thing is it's $50 cheaper. So you want to save $50 in your build for a similar CPU, you might as well go with Ryzen. I mean, it's a great build, great processor. The cooler on it is actually pretty decent. It will keep it in the 80s, won't downclock the your gigahertz on the cores too much. Overall, it's a better value. So I ended up giving the 3600 rather than going with the Intel. Again, bang for your buck. Another thing I sent him here. So for the board, I went with a B450. He doesn't look like he wants to upgrade anytime soon. You could upgrade, but you're not going to get the benefits of, you know, Gen 4 PCIe slots for like the newer cards and utilize it with the newer processors. But again, $129 for a board that has Wi-Fi, has USB 3, all these chipsets on it is actually a pretty good price for this board. And it's not half bad looking. The RAM, I went with 16 gigabytes, 3200 megahertz. A little bit faster. Will you notice the difference between the 3000 megahertz and the 3200 megahertz? No, I doubt it. Okay. Next, last but not least, the graphics card. So they're giving him a 2060 in this build, right? So if you look at a 2060 on Amazon right now, they're going from anywhere from $600 to $700. So we went with the 5600 for $449. I think we actually got a little bit cheaper than what's on here, But comparable, again, let's look at the benchmarks. So you look at them, right? So you look at your price points. It says 338, but you're not buying 338 right now. It's just not happening. You're getting $600 to $700 here on anywhere you're trying to find an RTX 2060. So we ended up with the 5600 that was in stock, and we paid $449. And you look at the benchmarks, I mean, you're not going to look too much closer. I mean, 20 frames in GTA. If not, you're getting the same in Overwatch, same in PUBG, same in Fortnite. So it's very comparable. And it's actually better in the benchmarks of effective speed over the 2060. The average score, the 2060 is about 7% faster. Nothing that anybody's going to really notice in game. Clocks, overclock scores, if you overclock them, you have, of course, value sentiment. You do get a little bit better value with the 2060. And NVIDIA has better driver support. But for the bang for your buck, you're going to spend almost double the amount of money to buy a 2060. Makes no sense to not go with the 5600. So that's what we paired it with. And for the power supply, they gave them 600 watt, which didn't have a brand on there. So you don't know what brand of power supply that you're actually getting with it. You just know that you're getting a 600 watt, 80 plus gold high efficiency. So on Amazon, 600, this is bronze certified, but if you look at the reviews on this thing, it has over 1,200 reviews, and it's 4.5 stars, way better. Now, I did upgrade a couple things. I put more case fans. On here, it just comes with standard case fans. It shows all the RGB, but you don't really know. It doesn't specify because you have the AIO. So you probably have one in the front and one as exhaust and two on the AIO. So to make it comparable, I bought the 3-pack in order to make it better, which was a 40 extra bucks, but still, it's not that bad. Now, coming out of everything, what price? I got them at $1,250.83 for the current price. So I ended up saving them $300, and that's even before shipping. This is with shipping in Amazon. On the other card order, this is without shipping. So he's paying $1,545 before he even puts shipping in. So you know tax and shipping is going to put this somewhere around $1,700-$1,800. So I end up saving him. If he wants to build his own, we end up saving him anywhere from $200 to $400 on building his own PC. That's very comparable and has upgradability. You can do a lot of different things with this. So this is just something I look at. I took time to research, hey, what PC you're building. I looked at the build specs. Okay, hey, what can I do to make it cheaper and get the same performance out of it? And I built a comparable PC to what he's getting over here. And I think he's going to be very happy with it. He's going to be playing WoW, Call of Duty, all different types of things. I had a PC downstairs that had a Ryzen 5 3600 with a 580, and I was playing Call of Duty, and it's running at 1080 at 60 frames a second on a 580. He's up, you know, stepping massively up in the graphics card. He's going to be able to play these games no problem at all. Not at all. So when we actually look at it, if he's willing to spend the $1,700 on that pre-build, and I got him down to $1,254, he can then take that $400 or $500 and upgrade other parts. If you want a better CPU, upgrade the CPU. Go to Ryzen 7 or Ryzen 9, where you can actually make a performance different. Or, hey, if you snag a 3060 or a 3070 or a 3080 out there, you have the money to do it, and you're still going to be paying the same price as you would the pre-build, and you'll end up with a better computer and end results. If you put these computers side by side and you took a normal user and said, hey, play Call of Duty on this Intel system on the pre-build, and then, hey, play Call of Duty on this system, tell me which one's smoother, tell me which one's the difference. The performance would be so close, a normal guy would not be able to tell. And that's where this comes in, is like, you have to take the time to do the research to save the money. If you don't want to take time to do the research, pay the pre-build money. Play the $1,700. And if you got it, hey, no problem. Go ahead and spend it and do it. If you want to save a little bit of money and have a better or comparable PC, take the time, research it, and build it yourself. It's a fun hobby I like to do. I've probably built 5 PCs over the last 4 months for different people. I got 2 more builds coming here next week that I got to finish up. One for a workstation for somebody who just wanted a simple build. And then I also have one that's this gaming PC that's probably going to put a video out for you guys. So, you know, please stay tuned. Hit the like, the subscribe button. You know, give me some comments down below on what you guys think of this pre-build and what you guys would do different. Or give me an experience where you'd want to save some money, or maybe you guys would like some advice. Hit down in the comments below. Let me know. Hope you guys have a great day. See you next time.